Hey guys, I am Lindsay here with First Six Pokemon, and welcome back to our review series. Anyways, our last review wasn't really much, but we did it so we can compare, so we can move on to this movie. Now they're both called Treasure Planet, one made by Disney and one in 1982. Ew. We got the 1982 version first to get the bad one out of the way, to get it talked out and over with, and tear it apart, which we did. This movie is very fantastic, and we heard very good reviews about it. When this movie first came out, it kind of bombed at the box office. However, it started getting appreciation throughout the years, ever since the year 2012 or so. Oh, and people came to like it. So, this movie was pretty much considered one of the most underrated Disney film ever. And they were all right. This is the most underrated Disney film ever. Sure, there's Brother Bear, her bear. Anyway, sometimes we usually teach us about Native American culture. Then to us, there's A Wrinkle in Time. Well, for us, which has a lot, which just feels magical like this. But this is the most, but this really brings around for underrated movies. As it came out, as it has as much or even more magic as it did A Wrinkle in Time. After a very bad time for them, one of the most popular Disney movies ever, back in the 2000s. And it's never hard to see why. And it takes a leap of faith into a magical world. It helps people follow their dreams at times. Really, this movie, we have a lot of praise for this movie. And we have more to say about it. That's older brother failed back in 1982. Yeah. And it really has more positive to it. And we really love this movie. Beyond any treasure of all. So now, give me Pokemon number two. My popular Poppy, my little Piplup, but really, really love this movie as our favorite Disney movie, and I just really love it. And we love how they, and we love how, we got there. Mm-hmm, how good it is. Yeah. So now, let's talk about the movie. Yeah. Because, this movie is about a young, this movie takes place, in the future, and during like maybe 25th, takes place in a futuristic, so this movie takes place in a future, in the very beautiful Earth. In a very futuristic Earth. Where a teenage boy, and there, live an 15-year-old boy, named Jim Starling. Hawkins, Jim Hawkins, who lives with his mom Sarah, and ever-moving pup named Douglas. Might have to check it out, but really like him. Really, everything's great about this movie. So basically, there's a lot great in this movie. Mostly with the characters. If we don't like all of them, they're fantastic. So anyways. Jim wants to stop messing things up for her mom and make her proud. As he's been going and getting in a lot of trouble ever since his dad left him forever, which might have caused him to go through a rebellious days. But when he finds out about Treasure Planet, that he read in books and that it exists, he decides to go find that place. He decides to go on an adventure to find it, and along with his smart dog assistant, and man, is he funny! He's a great comic relief character. Well, there's actually three comic reliefs. Professor Douglas is the first one. The other two are Morph, a little space blah. That's what you say to it there. Like, thumbs up for Ditto. And Ben. And who used to be who used to be owned by Captain Flint, who might have been Jim's father, and he kind of started out annoying, but we do sympathize with him, as we know that he lost his memory a long time ago, and we really wanted him to get his memory back. Heck, Ben is the least funny of the comic reliefs. The robot started out pretty annoying, but he is a little funny once you get to use him, and you get to like him better once we hear that he's trying to remember, or wants his memory back, which makes us want to sympathize with him. For the other characters, we have the captain, who is Anthropomorphic Cat, and man, she's pretty badass. She's pretty cool, and adventurous. And has some, and is just a very quick thinker. And does a great job at captain. Then you got. Then you got Wong. Then you got Wong. Who was the captain's right here woman before Dr. Douglas this. Anyways, to Douglas. Douglas, and when he fell into the black hole, thanks to Scorpio, Well, was pretty cool. Really, he's not much of a character as he was killed during the black hole scene halfway through the movie. But he's pretty cool. And we love how Charles Dr. Douglas said joy to be our next right hand man and help her show affection for him and become has some great character development as well as Douglas. And then there's Silver, the villain of the movie. Who plays both as a villain and a good role model for Jim. They have a nice dynamic. And his ending felt well deserved. Served as how he developed throughout how he developed his journey. I'm recording. Anyways, Sora is just pretty cool. And we love how he developed through all this. And we love how he helps Jim in the end. And he's the better person through all this. Really, the only characters I don't like are the one who makes farting noises when he talks. Fox and Scorpion. Okay, Scorpio. Really, the only character I don't like is the one that farts a lot. And Scorpion. Honestly, guys, Scorpion is the worst character. It's so mean-spirited. And it's so quick to get Jim in trouble. Which was at the asteroid field. We didn't get to see much of Wong. He fell in the black hole because of Scorpion. Being wanted to kill. Wanted to help. So get a treasure. Before Silver starts getting some character development. Oh. Scorpion is just, and Scorpio is just it's just horrible. He's like the worst character. We don't get any backstory about him. Any backstory of him, man. He's too, and is very quick to disobey others. Thank God he got what's coming to him. Him. Like, that Scorpion guy is a menace. That Scorpion guy is a menace. And we really love how Super Jim developed for learn for this. That's your affection for Jim and Scorpion. And how Scorpion was kicked out of the team. And after base obeyed him too many times. You gotta go to him. And Silver were just, this was fantastic. That's it. And we really love gets to become a better when hanging out with Jim. Because and really like all the characters are great. Really, it's these own two that it's these only two I hate since the one that hurts a lot is just pretty dumb. And the other characters and Scorpion is just as the most infamous character ever. Very impatient. Scorpion is just nothing. Yeah, okay, really, I think Scorpion. Yeah, it's just the Prince Hans.
Are you done in there?
Okay, really, you know what Scorpion is? Really, I know Scorpion represents it's another villain. We got it. Scorpion's a scar. Are from the Lion King, King of the Treasure Planet series. Like, he is just that bad. And I know some of you like Scar. And I know some of you would like Scar. But however, some people liking Scar now. But I still see others. I still hate him, and Scorpio is just even worse than Scar. That's how we can describe him. He's like Scar, but more devious. He's a mean-spirited. Like, thank God he got blasted into the lava. Pieces has three arguments. No other negatives. Pieces has three negatives. Nope. Pieces has three negatives. I say nope. So, I say sorry, but no more negatives. almost everything is great. It's those two characters that are bad. But everything else is fantastic. The story is just very well written, fantastic, has led to this bit. The animation is fantastic. I'm mixing hand drawn with computer animation, which we would love hand drawn to come back in the spotlight, and it's our favorite. And I say it's our favorite kind, and like hand drawn favorite. And this is the best kind of movie that we want. The ones and movies that have hand drawn and computer animated is the kind of movie that we want. And especially when we saw the Pokemon movies. And the effects are in it. Okay. Pieces and effects are fantastic. And the songs they put in, like, just pretty cool. Like, we really love those songs. Our favorite part of the movie. Yeah? Pieces and. Pieces. And like we said, our favorite part was the ending. The last 30 minutes. At least so. Really, we love how the robot was able to. We love how Ben was able to get his memories back. And how Silver's. And how everything goes to go very great in the end. And we love how Captain Silver was able to help Jim fixing his mother and become a better person. And it's very cute, and the ending is just beautiful. Well, Douglas and the captain, I think all together had kids. Kids, Morph went on to live with Jimmy's mother, as well as Ben, and as for James Hawkins and his mother, they were together. Because they really together, we just really love the ending, how they all come together. Because the movie was fantastic, the animation was great. Yeah, because the story was great, the characters were great, animation fantastic. Yeah, it's great. Everything's great about Treasure Planet. The only thing we hate are Scorpion and the character of Harding. I mean, you're only carrying it, right? Yeah. Because I say there's another thing that I have wrong. It will be that the movie does drag a little at times, but that's just my complaint. Okay, he says, really blushed about it. It's an underrated gem. The most underrated gem. Like, it's the biggest. Like, the most beautiful. Yeah, he says, really treasure about the biggest gem in Disney. Yeah, he's really treasure about the best gem. 10 out of 10. My Pokemon is the most underrated gem ever in Disney. The most underrated gem. And it's very beautiful. 10 out of 10. Treasure Planet is the most underrated gem ever. Treasure Planet is the underrated gem of all. Treasure Planet is the most underrated movie ever in Disney. Treasure Planet is a gem. 10 out of 10. And we recommend this, and it's to all people that are looking for something relatable. And for those at the age of 15, at the age of 13 and 15, and for those that really want, and for those that really want something to come good, 2000 from Disney. But I like some. I think I like a few movies from Disney at 2000. But however, I see that people hated it. Think it's one of the worst years for Disney, which is understandable. Yeah, people really love it. Fantastic, I mean, love it. Okay, you know, just love it. Yeah, this piece is so. Yeah, this piece is so. Go watch it while you still can. It's a great character story with great animation. What about characters and. Yeah, he says it has. Yeah, baby. Piece is a great story with well developed characters. There's great animation. And a very wholesome pieces and a very great message. Pieces and great about following your dreams.